Welcome to the Dog World TV. Your host is Ahmed Alif Oyeng. We met on the Dog World Show, and today we are visiting the Philmart Kennels within Kisumu in Mamboleo Estate. We are here to learn more about the activities that they do inside there.
Gula is a South African Mastiff, also known as the Boerboel. The origin is from South Africa. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Gula is female, 24 months old. She was bred by Japan's kennel. The sire was Odin. Then the dam was called Spencer. Mm-hmm. So Zula, we brought her from Nairobi. Mm-hmm. Yes, yes.
So just in case somebody wants to own this specific type of breed, is the best advice you can offer to that person?
Okay, the best advice I can offer that person, Boerboel is a large breed. It's a molossa type of breed. It's very big. It requires a very big compound. And their feeding regime is also not normal. You have to prepare.
Yes.
You don't just breed Boerboel like any other dog. This is a special dog. Mm-hmm. You see. So my advice is, if you want to breed this dog, you have to have a very big playing ground and exercise the dog a lot. And another thing, the challenges we have is the feeding. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because they eat. You know, a male Boerboel can weigh between 65 and 90 kg. Yeah, and a female is also close to that range. Mm-hmm. So you can imagine how they eat. Mm-hmm. The portion they eat.
So speaking about that, maybe like you say, like a child,
yes,
there's that age that when a child reaches, they become hectic even to control.
Yes.
So
yes.
At what age do you say it's maybe hectic when it comes to maybe rearing this breed?
The Boerboel. Like now this one is Cyborg. Cyborg is 9 months old.
Mm-hmm.
She's still a puppy, yeah? But you can see the energy she's having. You can imagine if she reaches 12 months. So the age of 12 months is very difficult because it's a transition age between childhood and adulthood. But you know, Boerboel mature up to 3 years. So they can still grow. They fill out up to 3 years. This one is still a small, small puppy. If you come here 2 years or even next year, you'll find that this is a different type of dog.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
But 1 year there, Boerboel, you have to do the basic obedience, language, and command training earlier. You see?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because that is, they grow fast, but they mature slowly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you can see that this is a puppy, but you can think it's an adult dog. They grow mm-hmm. fast. Growing fast, I mean, they grow in terms of the body size, because their body grows very fast. But now they mature slowly, because you can see she's a puppy, but she's playing. You see, like that one is 24 months, but mm-hmm. it has not even grown mature.
Mm-hmm.
After it has given birth, Zula, it will still widen.
Ah,
yes. Uh-huh.
So you see, like a human being, sometimes you fall ill. So what are the common maybe illnesses that they fall short for? I don't know.
So. Like now, like any other breeder, the common illness is tick fever. Tick fever is very deadly and fatal if you don't know the signs and symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
It is killing so many dogs. Yeah? It is killing so many dogs. Not us alone, but that is very common.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, there's this red tick. Yeah? It when it bites your dog, you won't know. 48 hours from now, the most important thing is to know the signs and symptoms. It is curable. If you give it a shot of imizole, you will cure the tick bone fever.
So in case of such illness, yeah, what remedy do you offer them?
Okay, first, like I said, the most important thing is the first is science. Because just like malaria in human beings, you have to know the science. So for any breeder, breeding a dog, you have to look at the urine. Urine, you get that it is the first symptom. The dog will be sluggish in walking, it will be dizzy. You see, then you will see the color of the urine. It's like Coca-Cola. It is important to know the signs first.
because you can misdiagnose. But me as a somebody that has bred dogs for long,
yes,
I know. But this is an advice that I'm giving to upcoming breeders and everything.
Mm-hmm.
That is the most challenging. Then another challenging thing, maybe us breeders, when we are doing breeding, is Pavo. Pavo now for puppies now. Mm-hmm. Like there's Rottweilers that I've shown you.
Yes.
If you don't do the vaccination on time, you lose all your puppies. Yeah, so because you know there's a regime of doing the vaccinations, you can do them other. I always tell other breeders, do what works best for you.
Mm-hmm.
But us, we start our vaccinations at 4 weeks. That is the first shot of Pavo. Then at 6 weeks, we do another shot of Pavo. But in that duration, we've done the deworming after every 2 weeks, 2 weeks, 2 weeks, after that 6 weeks. Then at around 9 weeks, we do a shot of DHLP. Then at 12 weeks, we do another shot of DHLP. Then we can do rabies.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that puppy is safe. Even if you sell it to a client, it's good to go.
Now, speaking about the veterinary doctors, do we have enough of them within Kisumu County, or is it posing a challenge?
In Kisumu, we have a lot. That is the advantage. As for Philmart Kennels, we have our personal vet that comes here every weekend. That is actually he's the one who was calling me. Yeah, so he comes here, he checks the dogs, and he's also staying nearby. So even if it is an emergency, it's 12 a.m. anytime.
Mm-hmm.
Anytime I call him, he just comes.
What about the general environment within Kisumu? Is it favorable with this breed of dogs?
Yes, it's favorable, but you know, Kisumu is hot. Now with the Boerboel and the Rottweilers, as you're breeding very large breeds, there's this heat stroke while you're walking. You remember the show?
Yes.
Most dogs, you were asking
those... I remember you pouring some water the Rottweilers.
Yes. You were asking those guys, why are you pouring water? It's the heat stroke. So the heat, the weather is hot. So you know, you should know how to manage. You should know how to manage the dogs during their walks. Like now, the sun is already out. Yes.
Mm.
So that heat stroke, you should be careful because it's dangerous with the dogs.
So I believe it's also another time to maybe also visit another breeder. So if
we can show you the males.
Yes, the males. Yeah, sure. Show us the males. Sure.
Then we go somewhere. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Bugatti is a crossbreed. We are the first breed we began with at Philmart Kennels. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So Bugatti, the sire was a crossbreed of a pit bull and a boar. Then it was bred to a German shepherd. So if you look at Bugatti, you can see the fur.
Yeah, German shepherd.
That is, if you look at the eyes, the eyes, the nose, the color of the nose, you see, there's something from more of the
Yeah. I can see we also have our friends. The Japanese
people. Yes. This one is around 8 years old.
8 years old?
Yeah.
And him?
Two and a half years.
2.5 years?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
So this is male? This is female. Yeah. No ladies. Yeah. This is 8 years.
Fancy.
Yeah,
very healthy.
Yeah.
So now, generally, as we go and we show us how we
do the training.
So in the general grooming, and well-being, comfortable usafi, and all that.
Yes.
How do you know that?
Every Saturday. Yeah, every Saturday we do the grooming. Yeah, maybe this Saturday you wash them, the other Saturday you spray them. Yeah, because we don't like washing them. They leave their fur. Mm-hmm. So normally this week you can wash them. Next week we spray them with acaricides and everything. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So that is our general way of doing the treatment.
So I think it's time for us to show us how they do the spray.
This is the official logo of Philmart Kennels. Philmart Kennels was established in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
And Philmart, you may wonder, why the name
Philmart? Yes.
So my name is Philip Martin Omoto. So Philmart was derived from Phil and Matt. Philip and Martin. M-A-R-T. Yes. Philmart. So that's where Philmart came. But now the kennels now.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So even in our website, just Philmart Kennels, the CEO, the KE. Instagram is just Philmart Kennels.
Yeah, but in Facebook, I'm just Philip Martin.
Yeah. So those are the handles that anybody wants to contact you in terms of the dog breed.
Yes, then we have a...
If they want to buy, that's where they can contact you.
They can contact me more so on Instagram. On Facebook, I'm Philip Martin. The moment you just type, you get me. Then our website is philmartkennels.co.k. You'll see more about Philmart Kennels on our website, on our storyline.
Yes. So straight away, let's see it.
So this Boerboel, this Boerboel is 11 months old.
This Boerboel belongs to principal of Sirembe Girls. It came all the way from Bondo to be trained at Philmart Kennels. Like I told you, our schedule, in the morning we clean our dogs. Then we start training the dogs that are boarding. You remember the last interview?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is one of the dogs that boarding for the next 3 weeks.
So he is a boarder.
He is a boarder. Yeah. So yes. This one is one of them. We have also the other two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let's go and see them.
Yes.
Where are the other two?
Yeah.
From which side? Long coat?
Yes.
Dark and tan?
Yes.
Wow.
So this one is all the way from Migori, just to be trained at Philmart Kennels. You see now that, because we are both, we train dogs, basic obedience, like in command, protection and aggression. You can see this dog already is like, she will protect the owner, very protective. And that's our job. Yeah, we do foundation for the dogs. For guard dogs, because nowadays people prefer dogs than watchmen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
how old is the? Yes. How old is she?
1 year 4 months. Mm. Yeah, 1 year 4 months.
From Igori. So,
Yeah. So you get the demand is high for the boarding. See, I told you our schedule we deal with the boarding, then we go to home here in Kisumu. So you can imagine our schedule is very reckless. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you see there are other homes that we go. But here we prefer bringing you dogs that are coming from far,
mm-hmm.
Boarding.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So as you show us maybe to the next. Before we go there, as you show us. So on average, how many households do you visit maybe here after dealing with the boarders?
Five. Five.
In a day.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Five in a day.
He's very excited. Yeah. Okay, let me show you one thing.
Thank you. Thank you. Sit down. Down. So, this must sit. So basically, this one is the Boerboel, and this is called the harness. This is a harness, yeah? And this is a choke chain. Choke chain. While training a Boerboel on aggression training, we have to have both. Boerboel are strong. Because this leash, normally they snap. Gizmo, sit. Stop it. Sit. So, that's why you will see most of us. We have the harness, and we have the collar or the choke chain. So that even if one snaps, you have the other one. Yeah. Yeah. They have a lot of strength. They have a lot of strength. Yeah, they have a lot of strength. And they're well trained. Yeah, they on command. Even if you can sit. You are near me, but it's not attacking you. Yeah. Sit. Down. You can sit. So when you the protection training, normally when he's a decoy. Now when you want the dog to attack the decoy, it's a command normally we use. To tell the dog to watch. You see, he's acting.
Yeah?
Watch. Yeah? Then the dog. Yeah.
I think it's time for action.
Ah, okay. It's
Watch him,
good boy. Watch him. Good boy. Watch him, Gizmo.
Good boy. Good dog.
You've been watching the Dog World TV, and as you can see, we visited the Philmart Kennels. Yeah, for yes. Philip Martin. Yes. Yeah, they've been arrived from the two names, and now what you've just witnessed is the aggression training.
Protection and aggression training.
Yeah, protection and aggression training. Yeah. And the inside one was about
the basic obedience, language, and command plus the free drive.
I'm so sure that you understand whatever Philip has said. Yeah, the play driver, basic language and commander for the dogs. You need your dog and be trained. This is the place. Yeah, it has been your host, Ahmed Khalif Oyeng. Remember, we are at Philmart Kennels in Kisumu, Mambo Leo. Please remember to keep subscribing to our channel, like, follow, and subscribe. Don't forget to press the notification button, such that each and every time we keep uploading our content, you'll be the first one to view. For now, it's a goodbye for you. Keep locked, keep tuned for the next episode. Bye bye.